Hi everyone, it's Monday, well technically it will be Tuesday in just 7 minutes, so anyway, it's finally time, Dark Ashura is here, this is the team I'll be using for the final boss of the 6th Dark Vision, and like I said in my last video, I'm pretty confident this might be a cap right from the get-go. So the boss does all non-elemental attacks, Zaun, as per usual, will be the one to passive provoke, evade, all that stuff. But I'm getting ahead of myself. Let's check out the team. So Cloud, the Neo Vision one, is using just straight DPS gear. He will chain with Lauren and with Zaun, I believe. Yeah, I guess he will. I already forgot what they are all doing. I planned this out. I do have my sheet somewhere over here that I'll be going through in just a minute to see what I'll be doing, because this is... It's gonna be a tough one to pull off, that is. Alright, so as you can see, I'm using a fair amount of STMRs over here. I'm using the 4th anniversary celebration card on Cloud, because Cloud's vision card is on Tifa to give her maximum amount of damage. So Cloud has 150% human killer, which is enough. We do have Starlight Elena to provide 200% additional human killer buff, so we are good over here. Let's move on to Starlight Elena. Now, her base form really doesn't matter, actually. As you can see, I still left her on some gear over there. So what we are actually looking for is her Brave Shift. She will provide some damage. Now, she won't be dealing top damage on this boss. She's actually just here to imperil, to buff the T, or get her her Water Imbue stolen from Zaun, and she'll just chip in some damage as well. As you can see, she does have some nice gear. Now, again, all very expensive. All 4 of those are STMRs. Weapon Specialist is from White Rose Therion. Love's Whereabouts should be from Terra? Is it? I guess so. Magitek Terra, that is. Tzu Radiance is her own, and Warrior of the Crystal is originally Lina's STMR, so it's quite expensive, as you can see. Not so much the equipment itself. That's quite easy, I guess. Anyway, I'm using her own vision card. It's still at level 7. I will power it up to level 8 by Saturday, once I get my 2 Cactuars. Alright, so much for Elena. Oh, by the way, she has only 95% human killer. Again, she won't be dealing the huge damage amount of on this fight. Now, I'm also using Xuan Wu and Qilong. They will be doing some decent damage, I hope. They do have 125% human killer, using quite some nice gear as well. Now, as you can see, I left 2 ability slots empty. The reason is quite simple, to be honest. I do not have anything better to equip them with. There's nothing else to add. I would love to get Knight the Leader. And I'm actually... Just let that sink in for a second. I would actually get Knight the Leader's STMR, because that one provides 50% human killer as well. And if this doesn't cap, I will STMR Knight the Leader. There, I said it. But maybe it's not going to be necessary, or at least I'm not expecting it to be necessary. Alright, so Mastermind Zaun. Now, as you can see, I did equip him for damage. He has 2.3k attack, so not too shabby. He's still passive provoke evading, as you can see. So the old usual. He does use some DPS gear as well. I mean, his damage won't matter that much. It's just every little bit helps. Now, we have Lauren. As you can see, I did gear her base form to provide as much Limit Burst Phil as possible. I do want to use her Limit Burst on turn 2. And should this not work, I will reset this fight forever until I get it. But it should be fairly quick. I do have 1150 limit fill per turn. She has 450 limit fill rate boost. So yeah, this should be good. Now, what's funny is, or not funny, but the selling point on Lauren is a Brave Shift ability, or Brave Shift per se. That one I equipped very heavily. As you can see, I'm dual wielding her, not single wielding or true dual handing. So she's using Searing Ember. Again, this is an STMR. It provides 75% human killer. I'm also using Muramasa, which is it should be a trial weapon. It's also providing 50% human killer, which is cool. She's using a fair amount of strong equipment, as you can see. I mean, four of those, the Storm Bunny Jacket, the Scanning Goggles, the Ravenheart, and Searing Ember, they're all STMRs. So, by the way, I'm not a whale. Just let me make that one clear, I'm not a whale. It just happened that I got all of this stuff. And yeah, as you can see, Man-Eater Plus on Lauren, just so we have 300% human killer. So she will deal a whole bunch of damage on this fight next to Tifa. And I gave her, well, I gave her the airship. What's it called? Vision card. That's the word I was looking for. I could have gone for the... Actually, let me just check. So, does the celebration card provide more? No, it doesn't provide any attack at all. So let's switch it back to the airship one. Now, I'd love to have another vision card from Cloud, but I don't. So that's what we gotta deal with. All right, so that's Lauren. And now comes the star of the whole thing. It's Tifa. Now, you can leave her base form naked. I would suggest that you use Lion Emblem just in case that Lauren does not fill her limit gauge anyway. I might just use Rallying Cry on the very first turn with Tifa because there's not much to do with her. I'm going for a turn 3 kill. I need to boost Elena's, or since Elena can use her Brave Shift on turn 2 and boost her human killer, we are waiting for turn 3 anyway. So yeah, I might just use Lion Emblem on turn 1 with Tifa. Now, her Brave Shift is the thing we are looking for. As previously seen on my previous videos, I didn't change much. So this might look kind of familiar, as you can see. This is the same vision card, the same abilities. So she's sporting 300% human killer, of course, I should say, and 270% limit burst damage. Now, if I had Cloud from, what's the name? Advent Children, that's the one. The STMR, which provides 60% attack and I guess limit burst damage, that'd be even cooler, but I don't have that. So yeah, here we are. I mean, 270% limit burst damage is still good enough, I suppose. And if I did my calculations right, she will deal 1.7 billion damage on her own. So we just need 400 million from everyone else. And I'm quite confident that Cloud and Lauren will deal more than that. All right, so that's the team. I will be stopping this video just in case limit gauge filling Lauren fails me. So yeah, just wait for a moment. I mean, it's instantaneous for you. So I'll see you in just a second. All right, I made a huge mistake. I kept damage, but I forgot to change the positioning of my units. That is kind of embarrassing. So let's fix that. All right, so Lauren moves over here. Now, Mastermind Zaun and Xuan Wu, whoops, change their positions. So, slot 4 has Xuan Wu, Starlight Elena's on 5, and Tifa's on 6. Okay, that's the correct ordering. I'll be going through this again. I will not upload the failed attempt. I was just stupid. But this works. It works perfectly. I cap damage. I way over cap damage even. So let's go into it. So I'm excited. This is guaranteed rank 1. As the 400 others, I believe, that are already rank 1. So yeah. Alright. Cloud is going to use Ignition on turn 1. Lauren, well. She's going to Peerless Blade, Blade of Devotion, and Unhesitating Will. She did not fill her B gauge, which is bad, but it's fine. I guess I'm gonna wait for the others as well. Xuan Wu is going to... I'm purposefully using the wrong order, by the way. Don't want to deal much damage to the boss in case there's any stupid threshold that I might trespass and her doing anything suspicious to the team. Because this is a tight fit. I'm telling you, this is a really tight fit here regarding resistances and all that stuff. So, Xuan Wu will use Black Tortoise G-Strike. So the team has one stack of Mirage. One stack of Mirage is completely fine for the whole fight. Especially when going for turn 3. Now Starlight Elena will Aqua Flow twice to imbue herself with water. And she's also imperiling the boss with water. And Stella Maris. Tifa will use Rallying Cry. And Mastermind Zaun will... I'm still trying to think if I want to attack with Zaun. So I can fill up the limit gauge of Lauren. Because if I'm not, well, the whole round is over pretty much. But because I really need to LB with Lauren on turn 2. So how much look are we looking at? I mean, this is looking pretty grim, not gonna lie. Is there anything I need? No. So I'm gonna use Catch Me If You Can and just attack the boss 3 times. Oops, that's the wrong one. Let's use AR. So please, not a single orb landed on Lauren. Oh boy, that's bad. Talk about being unlucky. Yes, oh my god, finally. Okay, that's great. So Cloud, well, he's AFK this turn. Lauren is going to Brave Shift and use Blade Waltz, which powers up all her relevant moves. Starlight Elena is going to Brave Shift as well. She will light, shall bathe the ward to boost her damage and apply human and demon killers. Xuan Wu will just use Black Tortoise G Strike. We do not need to do anything else, I believe. That does not matter. Nope, there's nothing else she can do to power up herself. So, where is it? Black Tortoise G Strike. There we go. Tifa is going to Brave Shift and use concentration because why not, and Awaken Fighting Spirit. I'm so irritated. Alright, and Mastermind Zaun will Critical Mirror on Elena, Elemental on Elena, and Projected Mirror. And here we go. So everyone's ready to go. The boss is going to do his attacks. It's only going to be one AoE attack, which we all dodged. And now we are ready to go and kill the boss. Cap chains, yada yada. and we're done with Dark Vision. So Cloud is using Focus Thrust 3 times, Lauren is going to use Twin Blade Dance 3 times, Mastermind Zorn is using Lethal Virus 3 times to cap with Lauren and Cloud. Xuanwu is using Tactical Fusion, Special Arts Palm Strike. Starlight Alina is using Crystal Purify All, and Tifa is going to cap. Alright, let's go! Alright, let's have Tifa cap. 144 chain, I know from hard from last attempt, this one capped damage, so this is going to cap as well, of course. There we go. Perfect score. Rank 1 Dark Visions. It feels so good. It feels so good. I'm not gonna lie. That is just plain awesome. It's my very first time reaching rank 1 in Dark Visions. And yeah, of course, we do get the buck as well. I don't care. There we are. Rank 1, boys. I'm really happy. And as you can see, there is rank ones already. I believe it's about 400. Subtract 40 of that for cheating, but I mean, what do you need cheating for? It's probably as sure as the easiest fight. And as you can see on my friends list, Punchy has rank 1, 2, January W is very close as well as Minerva. So I wouldn't be surprised if both of them will reach rank 1 as well. So yeah, oh, by the way, let's go through the cool rewards we'll be getting for rank 1 as well. So yeah, whenever the rewards arrive, I believe it's 2 weeks or even 4 weeks. I do not care about the emblem. 800 dark matter, meaning I will be able to get my Dark Visions rod up to maximum. 5 new vision EX tickets. Which will be used for Summer Phase if she releases this year. Let's hope for that. Or else I will be using them highly likely on Terra, maybe, or the what's what they're called, Kingdom Hearts units. Free 30% or 70% blue tickets, I should say. 10 NVEX tickets, freestyle though. And a guaranteed super trust moogle, which is awesome, and I believe it's a 100% trust moogle and 10 maximum king metal miniatures. So those are really good rewards. I'm super hyped and excited that this has been going this well for the very first time for me. So yeah, I got all the rewards. I'm super happy. That pretty much concludes everything. I'll be going to sleep in just a moment. Well, I will still be uploading this video though, just to get this out of my way. Then go to sleep. And we will be seeing each other, I guess, on a Thursday again for another pull day Thursday and more clearing stuff. I believe we will be getting a new Scorn trial, which I'll be doing, of course. So yeah, have a nice rest of the week and have a good night, I guess, if you're European as well. Goodbye.